Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today our topic is owner's equity. What exactly this owner's equity is all about, we are here to discuss that. As you can see, there's an extract that has been taken from the balance sheet. In the shareholders' equity, we have preferred stock, we have common stock, and other things like treasury stock, additional paid-in capital. So these are all the owner's capital, equity, preference, treasury, additional paid-in capital, accumulated and other comprehensive losses, retained earning, and so on and so forth. So these are all the part and parcel of our understanding. Let's try and evaluate. Now, what is the owner's equity? See, owner's ownership is in the business, that is the amount of the business assets. Business assets that have been owned by the business owner. In other words, it shows the amount the owner has invested in the business, minus, need to deduct any money that the owner has taken out of the business as withdrawal. So owner's equity can be defined as the residual interest in the assets that remains after subtracting the entity's liability. So starting a business requires, you know, the investment of the funds by the owner of the business, and these funds are required to invest in assets of the business. Such funds can either be invested by the owners through their own sources, or they can be borrowed externally. So this is a proportion of the assets that has been financed by the owners of the business. The term is popularly used in case of the sole proprietorship. In the case of the company from the business, the term is used for the stockholders because the business is owned by the stockholders holding the shares of the company. Both have the same meaning. It is only the form of the business. So let's check the formula for this. The owner's equity is going to be your assets less any liabilities that comes in the due course. So there's a thing called contributed capital. It is the amount that has been paid by the common stockholders of the company, that is, you know, the par value, the common stock. Then there is a thing called additional paid in capital. Well, the additional paid in capital includes the cash proceeds that is received from the common stock sales in excess of the par value. Then the next we have the retained earnings. The retained earning is basically the cumulative net income that has been not been distributed in the form of the dividend. Instead, it's retained in the business for the future investments and growth. We have the next item as the other comprehensive income. Well, the other comprehensive income includes the changes that resulting on account of the unrealized gains or losses in the investment. So on account of the foreign currency translation, that means, I mean to say, the foreign currency gains and losses that are arising on account of the conversion of the parent companies or the foreign subsidiary into local currency, and so on and so forth. So this is the equity, that is remaining interest in the assets of the company. Now this includes the contributed capital, preferred stock, retained earnings, the accumulated and the accumulated profit, comprehensive income. It is also referred as the, you know, the book value of the company. Now, because this equity is equal to the reported assets amount minus the reported liability amount in the balance sheet. Let's take an example so that we have a good eye view on this particular topic. Well, let's understand, you know, how to compute this equity with the help of some owner's equity example. There's going to be example number one, which says, you know, there is a company called ABC International. They want to know the shareholders' equity at the end of the financial year 2017. So as on the date, the company is having the equipment that is valued, let's say at, I'm going to write directly the amount, 5 lakh. And it has inventory also with them, which is valued at 2 lakh. And they have the business debtors standing at 4 lakh. So the company is also having a bank loan, which is standing at 3 lakh. They also have the business creditors standing at let's say 5 lakh on the same day. So what we know that, you know, the owner's equity is all the assets minus liability, right? So over here, the assets are the equipment, the inventory, the business data, less the liability, that is the bank loan and the business creditor. Well, the assets, equipment, inventory and business data, that is in total 11 lakh is our, as you can see over here, the total amount is our assets, and this bank loan plus business creditors, which is 8 lakh, that is our liabilities. So finally, this is the owner's equity. That's how we find. Now let's take the example number two. Let's say the company has a common stock that is standing at 5,50,000. They have the preferred stock that is standing at, let's say, 1,75,000. They have the retained earnings that is standing at $2,50,000. And they have the accumulated and the other comprehensive income, which is standing at $46,000. So they also have what we call as the investment in the company at a fair value, which is costing at $1,50,000. So, well, the owner's equity formula, that's the common stock plus preference shares plus the retained earnings and the other accumulated income and the comprehensive income and investment. So we'll try and figure out the amount, that is 5,50,000, 1,75,000 plus 2,50,000. Plus this is 46,000, so that's going to be 102,100. Investment won't be part of it. Let's say there's an unrealized gain which is standing at 30,000 in the beta company, which is already included in the accumulated and the other comprehensive income, and hence it is not included again for calculating the shareholders equity. So now this is basically the measure to assess, you know, how much a company's net assets that belong to the shareholders, and it also shows a company that is utilizing the net asset of the company. Now it also sees, you know, if there is any return in earnings which are not been distributed in the form of dividend and capital which is invested by the owners of the business. So a high shareholders equity, what does that indicate? It indicates that the business is mostly funded from the internal source and less amount from the external debt. So how the shareholders equity on the balance sheet is shown? Well, it is shown something like this. You know, there's a current assets, the liability and the equity details right in front of you, all the details. As for the IAS number one, the IFRS defines, you know, which the financial statements of the owner's equity are required to be prepared and how they must be presented in the statement of the owner's equity. So the statement of the owner's equity shows the changes in the capital and the balance sheet of the business over the reporting period. We have this details. Usually the statement of the owner's equity is prepared on the sole proprietor's type of the business. What we need to note that, you know, there also is the statement of the owner's equity, which changes in one of the required financial statements that are to be prepared in compliance with the accounting standard. So, well, that's it for the shareholders' equity. With this statement of balance sheet and the detailed discussion, one can easily analyze the movement of the equity and how things go about with this particular arena.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.